Hello, my name is Angie Wilson and I work with the Georgia Student Finance Commission. We're the state agency that administers financial aid funds for the state of Georgia. And today in this presentation, I'm going to talk about connecting to college and federal and state aid as well as gafutures.org. So this presentation will be for 9th grade through 12th grade, so any high school student. Now, at the Georgia Student Finance Commission, our mission is to promote and increase access to education beyond high school for Georgians. So we're here to help throughout the whole process. And this is just a picture of our agency. We are located up in Tucker, Georgia. And we have various resources that can help you throughout your high school career. Our website is gafutures.org. We also present webinars and presentations, and I am your GSFC representative. I'm available to help you throughout high school any way that I can be of assistance. That's what I'm there for. Now, when you're going through high school, you want to make sure that you're taking the right classes. So you want to think about where you plan to go to college, what you plan to major in, and make sure that you're signing up for the correct classes. You want to look at your college requirements. Some colleges require that you take certain courses before you may be admitted. You also want to be sure that you're confirming the number of credits you need to graduate. And also, you want to look at the academic rigor requirements for the Hope and Zell-Miller scholarships. There is a minimum of 4 credits required of academically rigorous courses, and I'm going to talk a little bit more about it in just a minute, but in order to qualify for Hope or Zell-Miller scholarship, you would need to receive credit in at least 4 of academically rigorous courses. And that could be an advanced foreign language, it could be an advanced math or science course, that could be an AP class, it could be an IB class, or it could be a degree level dual enrollment course in course subjects. Now, the dual enrollment program is available, and the dual enrollment program allows high school students to earn college credits while they are working on their high school diploma. And there are certain benefits to the dual enrollment program. Students can earn credits towards an associate's degree, diploma, or certificate. It allows the student to get a taste of the college experience. The student may be able to take classes that maybe aren't offered at the high school. It will also build the student's confidence and increases the educational and career opportunities of the student. And in most cases, required standard tuition, the mandatory fees, and the required book expenses are covered by the dual enrollment program. So if you're interested in dual enrollment, dual enrollment is available for juniors and seniors, 11th and 12th grade, may take any course that they would like. 10th grade students are eligible to take certain CTAE courses. So if you're interested in the dual enrollment process, please talk to your high school counselor and your parents. You must also complete the college admissions process, complete the dual enrollment funding application on gafutures.org, and for more information, go to gafutures.org. Now, every year in high school, there are certain things that you should be doing in order to prepare for college. You want to discuss financial aid and savings options with your parents. Make sure that you know graduation requirements and take challenging courses. Talk to your counselor about dual enrollment. And starting in the 10th grade, check your Hope GPA through your MyGAFutures account. Now, here is a college prep checklist. This one is for freshmen for 9th grade. You want to be sure to create a GA Futures account, and that's going to be at www.gafutures.org. Also, start finding out about AP courses and participate in academic enrichment programs. Start thinking about careers and choose classes accordingly, and use GA Futures to explore careers. And once you are a sophomore in the 10th grade, you want to continue to research careers and match those careers with college majors. Possibly look into skilled trade careers and look at the Hope Career Grant. Use GA Futures to start researching colleges. Be sure to attend college fairs or other college prep events in your area. Review college entrance requirements. Take the PSAT to help you prepare for the real thing. And think about how to spend your summer. Do you want to work, maybe volunteer, or take a college level course? As a junior in the 11th grade, you want to continue to explore career options. Be sure to research colleges by visiting their websites and use net price calculators. Go to a Probe college fair and your school's financial aid night. Take the PSAT NMSQT to qualify for scholarships associated with the National Merit Scholarship Program. Be sure to register for and take the SAT, the ACT, and or the ACCUPLACER exams. Search for scholarships on GA Futures. And schedule campus visits or contact colleges to request information. Now, as a senior, 12th grade in the fall, you want to make sure you're on track to graduate and fulfill college admissions requirements. Be sure to take the necessary admissions test, SAT, ACT, or ACCUPLACER. Pay attention to deadlines and apply to your selected colleges. Ask teachers and counselors to submit required documents to your colleges. And beginning on October 1st, you may begin completing the FAFSA. That's the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. Be sure to stay involved in after-school activities and make sure to work hard all year. Also, as a senior in the spring, you want to be sure to complete any last scholarship applications. Review your college acceptances, compare financial aid offers, and plan visits to where you have been accepted. If you have questions about the aid the school is offering, contact the school's financial aid office. And when you decide which school to attend, notify the school and submit any required financial deposits. Now, on GA Futures, we do offer a college search. So you can search for colleges based on different criteria. You can search based on location. Maybe you're interested in going to college close to home, or perhaps you'd like to travel to a different part of the country to attend college. You can search based on the setting. Are you interested in being in the middle of a city, or maybe you're more interested in a college located in a small town? Look at the size of the college. Are you interested in a very large college, or maybe where you may be somewhat anonymous? Or are you interested in maybe more of a one-on-one setting or smaller class size? You can also search based on type. There are research-based institutions. Maybe you're interested in a broader education at a liberal arts institution. Other considerations in your college search: are you interested in a co-ed college or same-sex college, public or private? Maybe you'd like to attend a college based on a certain religion, cultural affiliation, or maybe you're interested in evening programs for working or returning students. And another important part of your college search is to look at the cost and the financial aid available. Be sure to keep your grades up to increase eligibility for scholarships. Be sure you're searching for those scholarships, and be sure to complete the FAFSA. Now, connecting to colleges and applying, you want to review the application process and keep in mind there are fees to apply to colleges. Early decision or early action admissions may be something that you're interested in. Most early action or early decision admissions are due between October 1st and November 1st. You want to be sure to get recommendation forms completed. Draft your college essay and have it proofread. And November is apply to college month, so November is a good time to apply to the college of your choice. In November, a lot of times the admissions fees are waived, so that can save you a good amount of money. Be sure to stay on top of all deadlines. Make sure you're sending in the official transcripts, official test scores, any letters of recommendation required, and all financial aid applications. After applying to your college, confirm that your information has been received. Be sure to double check any other deadlines, such as orientation fees and housing deposits. And once you're accepted to the college of your choice, Compare financial aid offers with other colleges that you've been accepted to as well. Now, financial aid comes in different forms. Scholarships and grants are what you want to look for first because that's the money that generally does not have to be paid back. Loans are an option. Usually you want to put loans last on your list. Loans do have to be paid back, of course. And work study programs are a good option. Now, financial aid comes from different sources. Your federal and state government are a big source of financial aid funds. Your federal government, for example, that's your Pell Grant, your federal loans. The state government in Georgia would be the HOPE program, so that's our agency, the Georgia Student Finance Commission. But colleges and universities also will offer a lot of scholarships and institutional funding. You can also search for scholarships through professional and service organizations or employers and private companies as well. Now, there are different types of financial aid. So financial aid that is merit-based means it's going to be based on grades or test scores. And a good example of a merit-based scholarship is the HOPE scholarship. You have to have a certain GPA to qualify. Need-based funding means that that type of funding is going to be based on the family's income. An example of that is the Pell Grant. Non-need-based funding means it's not based on income. Example of that would be the HOPE grant or any of our HOPE funding. It's not based on income. Student or parent loans, of course, are an option. There are employment opportunities as well, such as the federal work study. The military is also a great source of financial aid and grants. For example, in Georgia, we have the Georgia National Guard Service Cancelable Loan, and at the University of North Georgia, we have ROTC grants as well. And then, of course, there are savings plans. You have the Path to College 529 plan available here in Georgia, and that's a good way to save for college, as well as you may have traditional savings plans. Now, on GA Futures, we do have a scholarship search, and here are just a few tips for your scholarship search. Be sure to start your search early. Don't wait until senior year, last minute. You can go ahead and start searching for scholarships as early as sophomore, junior year. Go ahead and start looking early. Don't stop at 1, 2, or 3 scholarships. Apply for as many scholarships as you possibly can. And be creative. Consider your family, hobbies, career interests, medical history, or even your college major to search for scholarships. And look for scholarships even after you're in college. There are a lot of scholarships available to college sophomores, juniors, or seniors. And don't pay anyone to help you find or apply for scholarships. This is something that you can do yourself. The information is available, and you don't need to pay anyone to help you do this. Now let's look at federal financial aid programs. There are basic eligibility requirements. You must demonstrate financial need or exhibit academic merit, depending on the type of financial aid. You must have your high school diploma or GED. You must be enrolled in an institution participating in federal financial aid programs. You do have to be a U.S. citizen, permanent resident, or eligible non-citizen. You must have a valid Social Security number, meet the drug conviction criteria. You must not be in default or owe a refund on any federal or state student loan or grant, and you must be registered with Selective Service if required. Now, Selective Service would be a requirement for male students. So once a male student has turned 18, they must register, and males can register between the ages of 18 and 26. And that is a requirement for all federal and state programs as well. So be sure to register if you are a male student. Now let's look at the different types of federal financial aid. The Pell Grant is available to undergraduate students with financial need. So as a senior, you will be completing the FAFSA, that's the free application for federal student aid, and you will be including all of your family's income information on that form. The federal processor will determine what is known as your EFC or expected family contribution. So the lower your expected family contribution, the more money that you would qualify for. If your EFC on the FAFSA is a zero, that means your family doesn't have really any resources to help pay for college. So with a zero EFC, you would qualify for the maximum amount of financial aid. For the Pell Grant with a zero EFC, that maximum amount for the year 2020-2021 aid year is $6,345. Now that's prorated as your EFC goes above zero. And once it gets to a certain amount, somewhere in $5,800-$5,900 range, then you would no longer qualify for the Pell Grant. You may qualify for other funding, just not for the Pell Grant. And again, the EFC, or expected family contribution, is not a dollar amount that you have to pay. It just helps determine the financial need of the student and helps determine the amount of financial aid. Another federal program available is the FSEOG, or Federal Supplemental Educational Opportunity Grant. This is for undergraduate students with exceptional financial need. So basically, you pretty much have to have a zero expected family contribution or EFC number in order to qualify for the FSEOG. Pell Grant recipients do receive priority, and you can receive up to $4,000 under this grant program. Not all colleges have FSEOG funds, and the funding that a college has will vary from college to college. So if you think you may qualify for FSEOG, you want to be sure and complete your FAFSA as early as possible. The TEACH grant is available for any student who is interested in becoming a teacher. It's available for undergraduate, post-baccalaureate, or graduate students who are enrolled in coursework to begin a career in teaching. The student must agree to serve as a full-time teacher in a high-need field in a public or private elementary or secondary school that serves low-income students, and students can receive up to $4,000 a year under this program. Now, it does become a loan if you decide not to teach as required. This is a great program if you're interested in becoming a teacher. Federal Work Study is available for full-time or part-time undergraduate or graduate students. Now, these are part-time jobs that are available usually right there on the college campus. The students do earn a paycheck. They earn at least minimum wage. Sometimes the jobs pay a little more, but they do earn at least minimum wage. Students earn a paycheck just like any other employee, but it is counted as part of the financial aid package. One thing to remember about work study is that jobs are limited and funding may be limited as well, so you would want to apply as early as possible. Loans are available through the Direct Loan Program. They're available to undergraduate, graduate, or professional students who are enrolled at least half-time. Now, the amount that a student may borrow depends on the grade level and their dependency status. The maximum amount for undergraduates is $5,500 up to $12,500. And then for graduate or professional students, $8,500 up to $20,500 per year. For dependent freshmen, the first year, the maximum amount is going to be the $5,500. And then as a sophomore, they can borrow $6,500. Juniors and seniors borrow $7,500. Now, there's also PLUS loans available through the Direct Loan Program. PLUS loans are available to graduate students or parents of dependent undergraduate students. PLUS loans do look at a credit history for approval, and the amount is up to the cost of attendance of the college minus any amount of any other financial aid the student receives. Now, the starting point for financial aid is to fill out the FAFSA. That's the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. So this is your first step in your financial aid search. The application is free, and it opens up on October 1st of every year. The time to complete the FAFSA would be senior year after October 1st or after. The starting point for the FAFSA is to create an FSA ID, and the FSA ID allows you to sign your FAFSA, and if the student is dependent, one parent would also need an FSA ID. We offer FAFSA completion events all across the state. You can check with your school counselor for financial aid nights, or any FAFSA workshops, and be sure to visit GA Futures for any events near you. And lastly, don't pay anyone to complete the FAFSA for you. It is free, and it is something that you would have to complete on your own, so be sure not to pay anyone to help you complete this. Creating an FSA ID is really your first step. You would go to FAFSA.gov, that's FAFSA.gov, and you would see a link there to create your FSA ID. Now you're going to create your own username and password, and it will ask you for some additional information. It will ask you for your email, your name, date of birth, social security number, contact information, and you'll set up some security questions with answers as well. So be sure to write down your FSA ID. Once you create an FSA ID, you will not be able to create one in the future. So be sure to write it down and be sure to use good information. Use good email, good cell number. Make sure your contact information is correct. To complete the FAFSA, you want to go to FAFSA.gov and log in using your FSA ID. Put in your information. You will also need to put in your financial information. Now there is an IRS data retrieval tool that can transfer tax data automatically for your parents or you yourself if you file a tax return as a student. On the FAFSA, you can choose up to 10 schools to receive your information. And be sure to include any school you're planning to attend, even if you've not applied or been accepted yet. And after you submit it, be sure to log back in and double check the status of your FAFSA. They will send you a student aid report. You just want to be sure everything is correct and be sure to make any corrections as soon as possible. Now let's talk about financial aid through the state. The state of Georgia has a number of financial aid programs, and at GSFC, we administer nearly 20 of these programs. The HOPE program is the most well-known. And there are several ways to apply for HOPE. You may apply by completing what's called GSF apps and or other state aid program applications on GA Futures, or you may complete the FAFSA as well. Either option would be the way that you would apply for HOPE or Zellmiller, FAFSA or GSF apps, or you can complete both. Now for the HOPE program, there are certain general eligibility requirements. You must be a legal resident of Georgia. If you are a male student, you must be registered with Selective Service. You must be in compliance with the Georgia Drug-Free Post-Secondary Act. You must be a U.S. citizen or eligible non-citizen. You must be in good standing on all student loans or other financial aid programs. You must be attending an eligible post-secondary college. And you must be working towards your first undergraduate program. The HOPE scholarship is available to high school students seeking a college degree. So you must be in a degree level program. We offer scholarships and grants. So we have the HOPE scholarship and the Zellmiller scholarship, but we also have the HOPE grant, the Zellmiller grant, and the HOPE career grant. And the difference in the scholarships and the grants, scholarships are going to be for degree level programs. The grants are going to be for certificate and diploma programs, and those are primarily going to be at our technical colleges. But let's start with the HOPE scholarship. So again, you have to be in a degree program, and you must graduate with a 3.0 HOPE GPA. Your HOPE GPA is going to be your GPA in your core courses. That's going to be English, math, science, social studies, and foreign language. It does have to be a 3.0 or higher. There's no rounding in the HOPE scholarship, so it has to be a minimum of a 3.0. You will also need to receive credit in 4 rigorous courses. There's no test score requirements for the HOPE. You don't have to have a certain SAT or ACT score for HOPE. And the HOPE scholarship is available at all HOPE eligible colleges. All public colleges in Georgia are HOPE eligible. So all of our University System of Georgia schools, all of our Technical College System of Georgia schools, and the majority of our private schools in Georgia are HOPE eligible. We do have a list and a map on the GA Futures website of all of our colleges in Georgia that are HOPE eligible. And HOPE pays In most cases, it pays the majority of the tuition. It does pay a different dollar amount at each school, and you can find out the exact dollar amount that Hope pays at your particular college by going on to GA Futures, and there is an award chart available, and you can look up your particular school and you can see the exact dollar amount that Hope would pay. The Zell Miller Scholarship is also available to students who are going into college degree programs. Now, in order to qualify for the Zell Miller Scholarship, a student would need a 3.7 Hope GPA, and again, that's going to be in those core courses, English, Math, Science, Social Studies, and Foreign Language. They also have to have credit in the four rigorous courses. Students must also, in order to qualify for Zell Miller Scholarship, have to have a minimum test score. They would need an SAT score of 1200 or an ACT score of 26. So the test scores do have to have those test scores in one test sitting, and students do have to take the exam before high school graduation. Students who graduate as a valedictorian or a salutatorian will also qualify for the Zell Miller Scholarship automatically. So valedictorian and salutatorian automatically qualify for the Zell Miller Scholarship. And the Zell Miller Scholarship is available at all Hope eligible colleges as well. The award amount, the Zell Miller Scholarship, will pay the full standard tuition at public colleges, and it does pay a set amount at private colleges. And we have those award amounts on GA Futures as well. Now, the Hope grant is going to be for those students who are going into certificate or diploma programs. With the Hope grant, we do not look at any GPA from high school, so there's no minimum high school GPA required. There are no test score requirements, and it is available at Technical College System of Georgia and University System of Georgia colleges that offer diploma and certificate programs. And the tuition amount is based on per credit hour. It does cover the majority of the tuition at technical colleges in Georgia, and we do have those award amounts available on the GA Futures website. The Zell Miller Grant is also available for students who are going into certificate or diploma programs. Now, with the Zell Miller Grant, there's no minimum high school GPA required. There is no test score requirement. The way the Zell Miller Grant works is that a student would enroll their first semester in a certificate or diploma program, and at the end of that first semester, if the student has a 3.5 GPA, then the following semester, the student would receive the Zell Miller Grant, and the Zell Miller Grant will pay the full standard tuition amount, and it will also go back that first semester and retroactively pay the student back for what the Hope grant did not cover. So this one is retroactive the first semester. The GPA would be checked each semester, and as long as the student has a 3.5, then the following semester the Zell Miller grant would pay 100% of the tuition. If the student does not have a 3.5, then they receive the Hope grant instead. And you can see the exact dollar amounts out on the GA Futures website. The Hope Career Grant is also available for students who are enrolled in specific certificate and diploma programs. For the Hope Career Grant, there is no minimum high school GPA required, no test score requirements, and the Hope Career Grant is available at Technical College System of Georgia schools and those University System of Georgia colleges that offer diploma and certificate programs. Now, the Hope Career Grant would pay an additional $500 if a student is enrolled in 9 or more hours. If they are enrolled 3 to 8 hours, they would receive an additional $250. 1 to 2 hours, $125. And if the student is enrolled in the truck driving program, they would receive $1,000 one time. Now, the Hope Career Grant, this is in addition to the Hope Grant or the Zell Miller Grant or any other financial aid the student may be receiving. Now, the Hope Grant is available for certain certificate and diploma programs, and these are industries that have been identified as strategic in the state of Georgia. And that means we have more jobs available than we have workers in these particular industries. There are over 338 different certificate and diploma programs, and they are in 17 different industries, and they are listed here. We also have a complete list of those programs available out on the GA Futures website. Now, this is a list of the HOPE eligible colleges. They are located in Georgia. On the left side, those are all of the University System of Georgia colleges. On the right side, those are all of our technical colleges. And in the middle column are all of the private colleges that are HOPE eligible. Now, a student, in order to receive HOPE funding, they do have to be attending one of these colleges. Student cannot go out of state and receive any type of HOPE funding out of state. It's very important that high school students keep track of your HOPE GPA. Keep in mind, your HOPE GPA begins calculating as soon as you step foot in high school, and it determines if you're eligible for HOPE or Zell Miller scholarships. Now, the HOPE GPA is different than high school GPA. The HOPE GPA is only those grades earned in core subjects. So that's going to be English, math, science, social studies, and foreign language. And you can keep track of your HOPE GPA by logging into your GA Futures account. Once you log into your account, you will click on My GA Futures. And then down towards the bottom on the left side, you'll see a link for My High School HOPE GPA. Once you click that link and you will select your high school, you should be able to see what your HOPE calculated GPA would be, as well as how many credits you've already received that will satisfy the rigor requirements. Also, if we have your SAT or ACT test scores on file, and we're able to match those test scores with a student who has an account in our system, then we do post those test scores here as well. You can also click View Your Detailed GPA Report, and you'll see a complete list of all the courses you've taken, which ones count in the HOPE GPA, and which ones have counted for rigor. Now, keep in mind, in order to see your HOPE GPA on the website, you will need to have your Social Security number in your profile. And that Social Security number in your profile has to match the Social Security number that your high school has on file as well. Your HOPE GPA would be definitely in the 10th grade, 11th and 12th grade. 9th grade, you would be able to see your HOPE GPA after your high school has uploaded your grades into our system. So that may not happen until the end of 9th grade year, or it could be the beginning of your 10th grade year before you actually will see your HOPE GPA. Financial aid award offers basically all have the same information included. Your financial aid award from your college will basically tell you how much it will cost to attend the school for the year, the amount of financial aid the school is providing, the amount your family would be expected to contribute, and any additional need you'll have to fund through other sources. Now, once your college has made a financial aid award offer to you, it will look something like this. This is two different colleges, and these are just some examples of what a possible financial aid award would look like. After you have been accepted to your college, you will be given a username and password to log into your student account at that on that college's website, and there is a financial aid section through the student portal, and you would be able to see your financial aid award there. We do have some additional resources available for you. We have the gafutures.org website. We have a lot of really good information available on the website. We also have a publication called Georgia's College Connector, and that is available on the website as a PDF version. It's available under resources, under marketing materials, and it has a lot of good information available as well. Our agency website is gsfc.org. And if you are a senior, FAFSA.gov, that's an important website for you. You can begin completing the FAFSA October 1st of senior year. And studentaid.gov is another great resource. This has all the information about federal aid as well as preparing for college. What is your next step? create an account at gafutures.org. Be sure to check your HOPE GPA to see if you're on track to be eligible for the HOPE or the Zell-Miller Scholarship. And if you're a senior, complete the FAFSA beginning October 1st. This is your representative map. This has my contact information. Again, I'm Angie Wilson. That's my contact information at the top. I do cover the South Georgia area. That's all of the counties down in South Georgia that are in the hot pink color. And again, this map is available on the GA Futures website. You can contact us. This has my direct contact information. If you have any questions or if I can ever be of assistance, you can contact me directly through email at angiew@gsfc.org, or you can call me 678-495-8101. You can also reach us through our call center. We have an 800 number. That's 800-505-4732. The call center is open Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5. We are social. Please follow us on social media. GA Futures is available on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. So please be sure and follow us. And again, our mission is to promote and increase access to education beyond high school. So anytime that we can be of assistance, please be sure and let us know. My contact information is available on the website, and you may contact me at any time, and I'll be glad to help you in any way I can and answer any questions you may have. Thank you, and I hope to see you and talk with you soon.